My son Noah wasn't due for 5 more weeks, but he had other plans. My husband Silas, God rest his soul, reached out to Maggie. Not expecting her to come, mind you, just to let her know my water had broken.
At that time, when did you expect Maggie to arrive?
We didn't expect her at all. At least not until after the blizzard passed. It was impossible.
Ferocious winds, buckets of snow.
So you thought you were on your own.
But Maggie set off. Her truck got stuck on the fire road and she had to check in snowshoes the rest of the way, which was a godsend considering.
Considering what?
All the things that went wrong.
And at any time did you or your late husband consider calling 911?
Even if we had chosen to give birth in a hospital, there's no way an ambulance could have made it in time.
So then what happened?
The birth was difficult. Baby was kind of breech, you know, so it took some doing to get him out. And then the umbilical cord was wrapped around his neck.
Take as much time as you need.
Noah's face was blue and his tiny mouth open and no sound came out, just this terrible silence. Maggie's hands took hold. She unknotted the cord and cleared his airway and I heard my baby cry. It was the most beautiful sound in the world.
One last question. Do you believe that Maggie Haldane saved your son's life that night?
Maggie's hands were God's instruments. With him working through her, she did save my son's life.